بسم الله. In this video I'm going to solve Cambridge IGCSE Mathematics Paper 4 May-June 2021 Variant 3. AI Yasmin and Zach share amount of money in the ratio 21 to 19. Yasmin receives $6 more than Zach. Calculate the total amount of money shared by Yasmin and Zach. The ratio between Yasmin and Zach 21 to 19. So the difference between them 21 minus 19 2. The difference $6. Now we can find Yasmin or Zach, but we need to find the sum. So we can add one more column. This is the sum. The sum of parts between Yasmin and Zach 21 plus 19 equals 40. Now we need to find the sum. So cross multiply, 6 times 40 divide by 2 equals $120. Double I. In a sale, all prices are reduced by 15%. Yasmin buys a blouse with an original price, $40. Calculate the sale price of the blouse. So 15%, this means 100. Decrease by 15, now 85. So before the sale, $40. Now I need to find after the sale, so cross multiply. So 40 times 85 divide 100 equals $34. B, Zach buys a shirt with a sale price $29.75. Calculate the original price of the shirt. So now we need to find the original price. So 100, 15, 85. Now we have the sale price, 29.75. We need the original, cross multiply. So 29.75 times 100 divide 85, $35. B, Xavier's salary increases by 2% each year. In 2010, his salary was 40,100. Calculate his salary in 2015, so after 5 years, and increase each year by 2%, this exponential growth. So the new salary is 40,100 into 1 plus 2 over 100 power 5. 44,274 to nearest dollar. Double I, in which year is Zafir's salary first greater than 47,500? So you can try to find which year. So we have the original 40,100 into 1 plus 2 over 100. Power t should be greater than 47,500. Now we can put different values for t. For example, we can try t equal 10 and see the salary. For t equal 10, the salary 48,882. So we can try number less. So we can try 9. T equal 9. For T equal 9, the salary 47,923. Now we can check if it is 8 or 9. Now put T equal 8. If T equal 8, 46,983, so it doesn't work. So T equal 9. T equal 9, this means after 9 years. And we started from 2010, so 2019. So the first year, the salary greater than 47,500, 2019. See, in January 2020, the population of a town was 5% more than the population in 2018. In January 2021, the population of this town was 2% less than the population in January 2020. Calculate the overall percentage increase in the population from January 2018 to January 2021. Now, from 2018 to 2020, 5% more. 5% more, this means it was 100%, increased 5%, then now 105%. 105% can be written as decimal 1.05. From 2020 to 2021, 2% less, 2% less. This means decrease by 2, so it was 100% and decrease by 2%. Now 98%, write as a decimal, so 0.98. To find the overall percentage, start with the amount 100. This is the amount. This is the original one. And multiply by the 2 multiplier. So multiply by 1.05, multiply by 0.98. You get the answer 102.9. This means from 100 to 102.9, so increase by 2.9%, so 2.9. 2a, y equal bx squared plus t. Find the value of y when b3x2t equals negative 13, so substitute 3 times 2 squared plus negative 13 equals 3 times 4, 12 minus 13, so negative 1. Rearrange the formula to write x in terms of b, t, and y. So we need x as a subject. So y equals b x squared plus t, transpose t to the other side. Now you have y minus t equals b x squared, then divide by b, so y minus t over b equal x squared, the last step square root, so x equal positive negative square root y minus t over b. Bi factorize 15x squared minus 2x minus 8. No common factor, this trinomial, so we need two brackets. You can use calculator to help, or you, without calculator, how to get 15x squared? You can try 3x and 5x. For 8, 1 times 8 or 2 times 4, we can try 2 times 4. Because it's negative, so we can try negative 2, positive 4. Now check. Negative 2 times 5, negative 10. Negative 10. And 3 times 4, 12. The difference between them, 2. 12 minus 10 is 2, but this negative 2. So now we can change the sign. So you can make this positive. And this negative. Now it works. Because now we have negative 12 and positive 10, so negative 2. Or you can use calculator to help. Solve the equation 15x squared minus 2x minus 8 equals 0. After we factorize, we can say that maybe 3x plus 2 equals 0 or 5x minus 4 equals 0. So this means 3x equals negative 2, so x divide by 3, divide by 3. So x equals negative 2 over 3. Or 5x minus 4 equals 0. This means 5x equals 4, divide by 5, divide by 5. So x equals 4 over 5. C, factorize completely. X bar 3 minus 16, x y bar 2. The first step to factorize, check the common factor. We have x common factor. So you are left with x squared minus 16y squared. This difference between 2 squared, we can factorize more. So 2 brackets. x the square root of 16y, so 4y, this is the square root of 16y square. Now plus minus. This simplify the algebraic fraction. You need to factorize the numerator and the denominator, then cancel the common factor. So for the numerator, if you have four terms, factorize by grouping, take 2 by 2. For the first 2, 2x minus 1, we don't have common factor, so we can consider that we have one common factor. And for the last 2, negative 4a and positive 2a, we can take negative 2a common. For the last 2, you are left with 2x minus 1, same bracket. Because negative 4a x divided by negative 2a, 2x. Negative 4, negative, positive 2a divide negative 2a is negative 1. Because positive divide negative equal negative. Now for the denominator, we have x common. You are left with 2x minus 1. Now for the numerator, we can take 2x minus 1 common. You are left with 1 minus 2a over x into 2x minus 1. Now cancel the common factor. So the answer 1 minus 2a over x. Number 3a. Those test scores last term were find the range. The range, the greatest value. Minus the least value, so 10 minus 6 equals 4. The mode is the most repeated or the most common, so 7. Now the median, the values in order, so we don't need to arrange them. They're already in order. Now take the middle value. You can cancel this one with that one, and this one with that one. And do the same. Now you are left with 8, so the median 8. So the median is the middle value after you arrange them. B, the cumulative frequency diagram shows the information about the time taking for each by each of 200 students to solve a problem. Use the diagram to find an estimate for the median. To find estimate for the median, you need to find the order for the median. Half times 200 is 100. Now from 100, draw horizontal line till you reach the curve, then go down. So the median 14. So 14. To find the interquartile, you need to find the upper and lower. For the upper, 3 over 4 times 200. 150. From 150 between 140 and 60, draw horizontal line, then go down to find the upper. Now the upper 15. So 15 minus, we need to find the lower. To find the lower, the order for the lower, 1 over 4 times 200, which is 50. And from 50 between 40 and 60, draw horizontal line till you reach the curve. Now the lower, 11, so 15 minus 11 equals 4, interquartile, upper minus lower. C, the test scores of 200 students are shown in the table. Calculate the mean. The mean is the sum of the values divided by their numbers. To find the sum, multiply 5 by 3. And 6 by 10, 7 by 43, 8 by 75, 9 by 48, then 10 by 21, divide by their number, which is 200, equals 8.09. Now, D. The height in centimeter of each of 200 plants is measured. The histogram shows the results. Calculate an estimate of the mean height. show all your working. Now we can make table just to help. We have 5 groups. The first group start from 50 till 80, so 50 to 80. Then from 80 to 100. Then from 100 to 110. 100 to 110. 110 to 120. And the last one from 120 to 160. 120 to 160. We need to find the number of each group. To find the number for the first group, the area represents the number. So we need to find the area. The area for this group, base times height. From 50 to 80, we have 30. So 30 times 1, so 30. So the number for this group, 30. We have 30 plants in this group. For the second one, from 80 to 100, we can find area, because area of the rectangle represents the frequency or the number of times. So from 80 to 100, we have 20. 20 times 3.5, so 70. And the area for the next one, from 100 to 110, we have 10, the base 10, and the height 4, so 10 times 4, so 40. Next one, 110 to 120, we have base 10, and the height 3.6, 10 times 3.6, so 36. The last one, from 120 to 160, we have 40. 40 times 0.6, so 24. So we have 24. Now to find the median, it's easier. We need to find the middle value for each group, then multiply by the frequency, then divide by the total number, which is 200. So to find the middle value for 50 to 80, add them, then divide by 2, so 65. From 80 to 100, 90. From 100 to 110, 105, then 115, from 120 to 160, 140. This is the middle value. Now to find the mean, multiply the middle value times the frequency, so 65 multiplied 30, plus 90 times 70, plus 105 times 40, plus 115 times 36, plus 140 times 24, then divide by 200, equals 99.75. Number 4, A is the 0.15, B is the 0.39, M is the midpoint of AB, find the coordinates of M. So the midpoint, 1 plus 3 over 2, x plus x over 2, y plus y over 2, so 5 plus 9 over 2. So 4 divided by 2 equals 2. 5 plus 9, 14 divided by 2, 7. So 2 and 7. Find the equation of the line that is perpendicular to AB and pass through M. Give your answer in the form y equal mx plus c. So now you need to find the gradient of AB. Gradient of AB. y2 minus y1 over x2 minus x1. So 9 minus 5 over 3 minus 1. 9 minus 5, 4, over 3 minus 1, 2, so equals 2. So the gradient of the perpendicular, negative reciprocal, so negative 1 over 2. So the equation of the perpendicular, y is negative 1 over 2x plus c. This line passing through the point 2 and 7, so now substitute by x and y. So 7 is negative 1 over 2 times 2 plus c. So negative 1 over 2 times 2, negative 1, transpose negative 1 to the other side by positive. So c equals 8. Now the equation of the line y equals negative half x plus 8. B, the position vector of B is negative 2, 3. And the position vector of Q negative 2, 5. Find the vector BQ. The vector BQ equals Q minus B. So Q minus B, negative 2 minus negative 2, 0. 5 minus 3, 2. So 0 and 2. R is the point such that BR equal 3BQ. Find the position vector of R. We need to find BR. We don't have R. So we can consider that R, the position vector for R, X and 1. Now BR equals R minus B equals X and Y minus negative 2 and 3 equals X minus negative 2, X plus 2, Y minus 3. This BR. 3BQ, we have BQ multiplied by 3. So 3BQ, 3 times 0 equals 0, 3 times 2 equals 6. Now 3BQ equals 0 and 6. BR equals X plus 2 and Y minus 3. Equate them. So X plus 2 and Y minus 3 equals 0 and 6. X plus 2 equals 0. This means X equals negative 2. Y minus 3 equals 6. Transpose negative 3 to the other side. So Y equals 9. So the position vector for R negative 2 and 9. See, OT is vector T, OU is vector U, UY is double YT. Find OY in terms of T and U, OY. So to find OY, OY equals OT plus TY, or OY equals via U, OU plus UY. So if we consider that OY equals OT plus TY, OT equals T. TY part from TU. The ratio between them, this double that one, so this two and this one. So if we add all, so we have three bars in all. UT three bars. So UY 2 over 3 and this 1 over 3. So TY 1/3 TU. So this 1/3 TU. Now for TU, you can find TU. TU is negative T, because opposite direction, negative T plus U, negative T plus U. So equals T plus 1 over 3, and TU, which is negative T plus U. Now expand and simplify. So T, 1 over 3 times negative T, so negative 1 over 3 T. 1 over 3 times U, so 1 over 3 U. Now combine the like terms. 1 minus 1 over 3 is 2 over 3, so 2 over 3. T plus 1 over 3 U. Z on OT, and YZ is parallel to U. O means YZ, so this Z, this one is parallel to that one. Find OZ. We need to find OZ. Now we have ZY parallel to OU. So this means this triangle is similar to the large one because the angles are equal. And if the two triangles are similar, so the sides are proportional. So the ratio between this side and that one is the same like the ratio between this side and that one. The ratio between TY and TU, 1 to 3. So the same ratio between TZ and TO, 1 to 3. So this means this one, ZT, 1/3 T. So OZ, 2/3 T. 2/3 T. Number 5, solve the simultaneous equation. X plus 2Y equals 13. X plus 5Y equals 22. Look for the coefficient of X, 1 and 1. So if you subtract, you can eliminate Y. 2y minus 5y, negative 3y. 13 minus 22, equals negative 9 divided by negative 3 divided by negative 3, so y equals 3. Now to find x substitute, so x plus 2y, 2 multiply 3 equals 13, so x plus 6 equals 13, so x equal 13 minus 6, which is 7, so x equals 7. B, solve the simultaneous equation y equal 2 minus x, and y equal x squared plus 2x plus 2, 1 linear and 1 quadratic. From the linear, substitute in the quadratic. So 2 minus x equals x squared plus 2x plus 2. Put them in one side. So negative x and 2 go to the other side by different sign. So x squared, negative x go to the other side by positive. And we have 2, so we have 3x. And we can cancel 2 with 2. This equals 0. Now we can solve by factorization. X into x plus 3 equals 0. So a 2 values, x equals 0. Or x plus 3 equals 0. This means x equals negative 3 if we transpose 3 to the other side. Now for each value for x, you can find y. Y equals 2 minus x. So if x is 0, so y equals 2 minus 0, which is 2. Now if x equals negative 3, y equals 2 minus negative 3, minus negative 3, so equals 5. Now the two solutions, 0 and 2, negative 3 and 5. Number 6, in a class of 24 students, 18 students like homework, H, 15 students like tests, T, and 1 student doesn't like homework and doesn't like tests. Complete the Venn diagram. For to find the number in each region, we have 24 in all, and we have 1 outside, so H union T equal 24 minus 1 equal 23. So H, number of H union T equals 24 minus 1 equals 23. So the union for H and T, 23. But if we add all H plus all T, so number of H plus number of T equals 18 plus 15 equals 33. The union 23, but if we add them, we get 33. So this means the common, the intersection between them is 10, because 33 minus 23. So to find the intersection, to find the number of H intersect T, to find the common students in both, just subtract 33 minus 23 equals 10. So we have 10 at the middle. 10 repeated. Like homework and test at the same time. So now to find this number, we have 18 in H. So 18 minus 10, so we have 8. And for tests, we have 15. So 15 minus 10, then we have 5. Now write down the number of students who like both homework and test. We have 10. Find number of not H intersect T, not H intersect T, not H all the region around H. This region contains 5 and 1. Intersect T, we have 5. We have 5 only. So not H all the region around H. This intersect T at this region. This region contains 5 elements, so n equals 5. D, a student is picked at random from the class. Write down the probability that this student likes test but doesn't like homework. Like test but doesn't like homework, we have only 5. 5 from 24. So the probability 5 over 24. Two students are picked at random from the class. Find the probability that both students do not like homework and do not like tests. Do not like homework and do not like tests. We have one student doesn't like homework and tests, so we cannot choose two. So this 0. If two of the students who like homework are picked at random, we have 18 students like homework. We need to choose two of them, such that find the probability that both students also like tests. From 18, we have 10 like tests. We need to choose two from those. So for the first one, we have 10 to choose, so 10 over 18. And for the second one, 9 over 17 equals 5 over 17. 7a, write down the inequality in x shown by the number line. We have all the numbers between negative 2 and 1 included 1. So we can write x more than negative 2 because negative 2 is not included because the circle not shaded, and less than or equal 1 because 1 included because the circle shaded. Bi, write x squared plus 4x plus 1 in the form x plus b all squared plus q. So x squared plus 4x can be written x plus 2 because I have 4, 2, all squared minus 2 squared, then plus 1. We can simplify more, so x plus 2 all squared, negative 4 plus 1, so negative 3. Use your answer to part bi to solve the equation. So we can write the equation x plus 2 all squared minus 3 equals 0. Now transpose negative 3 to the other side by positive. So x plus 2 squared equals 3. Now take square root. So x plus 2 equals positive or negative 3. Transpose 2 to the other side by negative. So x equals negative 2 plus minus square root of 3. Now use your calculator to find the two roots, so negative 2 plus root 3 and negative 2 minus root 3. So negative 0.268 to 3 significant figure. The other value, negative 3.73. Triple I, use your answer to part BI to write down the coordinates of the minimum point on the graph y equal x squared plus 4x plus 1. So now y equal x plus 2 all squared minus 3. The vertex form, we can find the minimum point or the maximum point, in this case minimum point. It changes the inner, so this will be negative 2, and keep the outer, so negative 3. On the diagram, sketch the graph y equal x squared plus 4x plus 1. Now we have the vertex, negative 2 and negative 3. So we can consider this negative 2 and negative 3. And because the coefficient of x squared positive, so it will be open upward. It's better to find the intersection with y-axis. You can put x equal 0, so y equal 1. So this curve intersects y-axis at 1. So now you can draw the curve like that. This is our curve. Number 8a. A solid cuboid measures 20 cm by 12 cm by 5 cm. Calculate the volume of cuboid. Volume length by weight by height. So 20 times 12 times 5 equals 1200 cm cube. Double IA, calculate the total surface area of cuboid. We have formula for total surface area equals 2 bracket length width plus width height plus length height. So 20 times 12 plus 12 times 5 plus 20 times 5 equals 800 cm². Now for B, the surface area of the cuboid is painted. The cost of the paint used $1.52. Find the cost to paint 1 cm² of the cuboid. Give your answer in cent. So to find the cost of 1 cm², you need to divide the total cost by the total surface area. The total cost is $1.52. To convert to cent, multiply by 100. So 152 cents. Now divide 152 by 800 to find the cost of 1 cm² equals 0.19. B, a solid metal cylinder with radius x and height 9x/2 is melted. All the metal is used to make a sphere with radius r. Find r in terms of x. Because all the metal is used, so volume of cylinder equal volume of sphere. Volume of cylinder equal volume of sphere. Volume of cylinder is pi r square times height, so pi r square, so this means x square, times the height, which is 9x/2, equals volume of sphere, which is 4/3 by r power 3. Now we need r in terms of x, so we can cancel pi with pi. And now if we simplify the left hand side, then we have 9x/3, because x/2 times x/1 equal x/3 over 2 equals 4/3 r power 3. Both sides by 4/3. Divide by 4/3. 9/2 divide 4/3 equals 27/8. So 27/8 x/3 equals r/3. Now take cubic root for both. So r equal 3/2x. 3/2x. See? The diagram shows a cylinder of length 150 cm on horizontal ground. The cylinder has radius 20 cm. The cylinder contains water to the depth of 5 cm as shown in the diagram. Calculate the volume of the water in the cylinder. The volume of the water, just like a prism. So to find the volume of the water, you have to find the area of a cross section, area for this segment. Then multiply by 150, because volume of a prism, area of cross section times the length. Now to find the area for this segment, area of segment equal area of sector minus area of triangle. To find area of sector, we need to find this angle. Now if we join this side, because the radius 20, so 20 minus 5, so this 15. So we need to draw this triangle outside. So now this side 15, because 20 minus 5. And now this 20. Then we can find this angle. We can find this angle. For example, if this angle theta, we have the adjacent and we have the hypotenuse. So theta equals cosine inverse 15/20 equals 41.4. Now, so this angle, the whole one, 2 theta multiplied by 2, 41.4 times 2. Equals 82.8. So now this angle 82.8. So to find the area of segment, or the cross section equal area of sector, which is 82.8/360 times pi r squared, pi times 20 squared, minus area of triangle, which is half times 20 times 20 sine 82.8 equals 90.6 centimeter square. Now the volume of the water equal area of a cross section 90.6 times 150 equals 13,591 centimeter cube. Now I need the answer in liters, so you need to divide by 1000 from centimeter cube to liter, divide by 1000. So the volume in liters divide by 1000, so 13.591, so approximately 13.6 liters. 2-3 significant figure. 9a, calculate the perimeter of a quadrilateral ABCD. So we need to find all sides. From this right angle triangle, we have angle and we have the hypotenuse, then we can find AB and AD. To find AD, we can use sine 35 equals AD over the hypotenuse, which is 14. So AD equals 14 sine 35 equals 8.03 centimeter. By the same way, we can find AB cosine of 35 equals AB, the adjacent, over the hypotenuse, which is 14. So AB equals 14 cosine of 35 equals 11.5 centimeter. Now, for the other triangle, we have two angles and sides, so we can use sine rule. But we need to find this angle, 180 minus 60 minus 45 equals 75, so this angle 75. Now we can use sine rule. Fourteen over sine 14 over sine 75 equal DC over sine 45 equal BC over sine 60 equal DC over sine 45 equals BC over sine 60. Now cross multiply, you can find DC. DC equal, to find DC, 14 multiply sine 45 divide sine 75 equals 10.25 to 2 decimals, and for BC you can find BC, 14 sine 60 divide sine 75 equals 12.6. Now add all to find the perimeter, so the perimeter equal 10.25 plus 12.6 plus 8.03 plus 11.5 equals 42.38. B, the diagram shows a cube. The length of the diagonal AB is 8.5. Calculate the length of an edge of a cube. If we consider that the side of the cube x, or the edge of cube x, so the diagonal, so diagonal square equal x square plus x square plus x square. So diagonal square equal 3x square. So diagonal, we have the diagonal 8.5, so 8.5 square equal 3x square. Now divide by 3, so x squared equal 8.5 square divided by 3. Now to find x, square root the answer, so 8.5 square divided by 3, then find square root, equals 4.91 to 3 significant figure. Double I, calculate the angle between AB and the base of a cube. So the diagonal intersects the base at A, And if we drop from B perpendicular to the base, so this the position, now join the diagonal at the base. So now we need to find this angle. We have the opposite, which is X, which is 4.91, and we have the diagonal, which is 8.5. So with sine inverse, we can find the answer, the angle. So theta equals sine inverse 4.91 over the diagonal, which is 8.5, equals 35.3. Number 10, we have F and G, H, J. Find F2, F2 put x equal 2. So 3 times 2 minus 2, so 6 minus 2 equals 4. Find G2, so put x equal 2 in Gx, so 5 times 2 minus 7, 5 times 2 10, 10 minus 7 3. Next one, GF2. To find GF2, you need to find F2, we did before, this 4, so we need to find G4. So put 4 in G, so 5 times 4, 20, minus 7, 13. Find f negative 1 of x, so I need the inverse for fx. So put fx equal y, so y equal 3x minus 2. Now make x the subject, so negative 2 go to the other side by positive, so y plus 2 equal 3x, then divide by 3, so x equal y plus 2 over 3. So the inverse is switch y to x, so x plus 2 over 3. Now C, find hfx, so put f in h. So hfx equal 3x minus 2 all squared plus 3x minus 2. You can expand 3x minus 2 directly or multiply 3x minus 2 times 3x minus 2. So directly, 3x times 3x, 9x squared. And negative 2 times negative 2, positive 4. If the middle term negative, so this negative. 2 times 2, 4, multiply 3, 12, so 12x. Plus 3x minus 2. So combine the like terms, so 9x squared, negative 12 and positive 3, so negative 9x, 4 and minus 2, so equals 2, so plus 2. D, finds the derivative of hx. A derivative for hx, a derivative for x squared, 2x, a derivative for x1, so 2x minus 1, 2x plus 1. Find x when j negative 1 of x equal 4. J negative 1 of x. We cannot find the inverse for this function. But we can rewrite this equation as x equal j of 4. So you can transpose j negative 1 to the other side by j. So x equal j of 4. So put x equal 4. So this will be 3 bar 4 equals 81. Simplify j negative 1, j of x. J negative 1 and j, the function and the inverse, cancel each other, so the answer equal x. Number 11a, there are the first four terms of a sequence, write down the next term, 11, 7, 3, negative 1, so each time, minus 4, so the next term, negative 1, minus 4, so negative 5. Write down the term-to-term rule for this sequence. Term-to-term, we subtract 4 each time, so this minus 4. Now find the nth term of this sequence. To find the nth term of this sequence, each time we subtract 4, so negative 4n plus what or minus what, we need to go one step back. 7 plus 4, 11, so 11 plus 4, 15. So plus 15. Or you can use the rule, which is a plus n minus 1 into d. A is the first term, which is 11, plus n minus 1 multiply d, which is the common difference. In this case, negative 4. Then if you expand 11, negative 4 times n, negative 4, n, negative 4 times negative 1 is positive 4. So you get the same answer, negative 4 n plus 15. So you can use that one, or you can solve directly. D, the nth term of a different sequence is 2n over n plus 1. Find the difference between the fifth term and the sixth term of this sequence. So the fifth term, put n equal 5. So the fifth term, put n equal 5. So 2 times 5 plus 5 over 5 plus 1. So 10 over 6. In the simplest form, 5 over 3. The sixth term, put n equal 6, so 2 times 6 plus 6 plus 1, so 12 over 7. To find the difference between them, subtract, so 12 over 7 minus 5 over 3, multiply the denominator, 3 times 7 is 21, then cross multiply. 12 multiplied 3, 36, minus 5 times 7, 35, so 1 over 21. Double I, 83 over 4 is a term in this sequence. Equate the nth term, which is 2n, over n plus 1, by 3 over 4, and find the value of n. If n positive integer, so it's correct. So 3 over 4 belongs to the sequence. If not, so there is no term 3 over 4 in this sequence. Now cross multiply to find n. 4 times 2n is 8n. 3 times n plus 1, so 3 times n equals 3n. 3 times 1 equals 3. Now 3n go to the other side by negative. So 8 minus 3, 5. So 5n equals 3. Divide by 5, so n equals 3 over 5. This is not positive integer, so... So a 3 over 4 is not a term in this sequence.